E dicevo, gli ospiti che abbiamo questa mattina sono ragazzi, è stato un evento molto molto importante.
I consider it to be a wonderful event. There were 6,000 participants, 200 speakers, and in the end, over 600 ideas were collected.
It's pretty exciting, actually. The European Youth Event in 2014 was already very exciting to have a full room of young people and also some older people, and to actually have them listen to your proposals and to be invited to come again and come with new proposals that were gathered from all those 600 proposals that were mentioned last time is actually pretty much an honor, and I actually really enjoyed it.
It was a great feeling. It was a really unique experience of having the opportunity to being listened to. We had a really nice interaction and dialogue with the MEPs, and the feeling that we actually stand on the same side in many topics. Therefore, but I really hope it will be just like the first step on more cooperation between young people and decision makers.
A livello europeo, ma è uno spunto su cui sarebbe bello tornare per capire come davvero possiamo dare un impulso.
Ich halte es für besonders wichtig, dass wir als Mitglieder dieses Parlaments uns die Ideen der Jugend, die die Zukunft Europas sind, anhören. Und Ideas for a Better Europe, würde ich sagen, sind immer herzlich willkommen.
The first idea in the energy area that I've been looking at was to see about getting the European Parliament to support affordable, renewable energy and to have a focus of being coal-free by the year 2030.
First idea was about creating an energy union. With the point of it is to have like joint purchases of energy and also diversification of both external and internal sources of energy to create more solidarity and also foster EU's energy independence.
The first proposal was to have the European Union urge member states to create free Wi-Fi spots at public places.
The second idea was about creating, it was about digital democracy and creating the European online public space with digital tools such as online voting, online consultations on decision-making processes.
My second idea was to limit the possibilities for companies that work with private data, to limit them in their exploitation of consumers' rights by limiting their the length and difficulty of their terms and conditions.
Le fait qu'il faille défendre les énergies renouvelables, on est pour. Hein. Je pense que le Parlement européen, la Commission a pris des engagements là-dessus.
First of all, joint purchases of energy by EU member states.
Les conséquences de l'utilisation de l'électricité, je pense qu'il faut regarder comment on produit l'électricité. Et là, ce que vous dites, c'est un peu, je crois, que l'idée que nous défendons au Parlement européen.
Researching into the future of green energies, because they know it is the future and they know that in reality they're going to make a lot of money out of it eventually.
This European Youth Event was a great platform for like for exchange of experiences and getting to know a lot of youth organizations, since there were like 6,000 young people. So for sure it's a boost for even more cooperation. And I'm sure this is like a very motivating push for continuing advocacy, dialogue with stakeholders and work on some of our topics we are involved in, like for instance working on the visa directive.
I hope that it will help actually young people in general, because one of my main purposes of being here was to put youth issues on the agenda. And I think with the proposals that I came up with, the MEPs might now have something to discuss about.
Thank you very much for your inputs and for the interaction with us.